All right, so we got the Sun in Aries at the moment. So we starting off a new season. But this season is bringing initiative sparks, initiative passions, initiative motivations. So, of course, this is the rise in Phoenix right here. This is putting yourself into the perception of being direct and aggressive towards what you need to accomplish and conquer. So this is going to be that charge. It's going to be that martial energy that you need to utilize wherever you got that perspective at. See, when the Sun was in Pisces, we was paying attention to our dreams, our imaginations, and of course, our deep desires. We also got Jupiter there. We also had Neptune there. And of course, we had the Mercury there and the Sun there. Now, being that the Sun is now in Aries, it's time to basically be very direct towards your aims, your goals, and of course, what you're trying to manifest. Tomorrow will be, what, March 21st? Today is just like the peak. So when we get into that 3-degree spectrum, which is dealing with your environment and of course your surroundings, this is going to be the time to basically go ahead and see about areas where you can be very initiative and passionate and direct towards facing it and of course go and get it. So this is basically the self-starter energy. Also, the Sun is exalted in Aries, so that means you can basically overwhelm and of course go to the extremes of outburning yourself and of course depleting yourself. But make sure you're in the process of bringing equilibrium and balance as well in this equation and not trying to basically ruffle any too much feathers in that perception. You want to make sure that whatever you're trying to achieve, whatever you're trying to be dominant at, you want to go ahead and make that a consistency. You want to make sure the bridge is not being burned, but you want to make sure the bridge that you had projected is a new bridge, is a new start, is a new way to basically keep pushing forward, is a new way to basically keep going ahead and chewing off every piece that you can bite. And of course, this is time to get real personal towards your dreams and your goals. We got, what, 365 days? We're already in a new start. So, of course, once you experience that cycle from spring to summer to fall to winter, you know that you shouldn't basically be wasting your time. You already knew what it was hitting for. So now it's time to go ahead and basically get the red winner. Go ahead and keep pushing, starting yourself. Get the push start going, get the push start flowing. And then when you get these spectrums rolling and going and everything, can start basically processing. But you want to make sure whatever you're trying to aim for, whatever you're trying to spark, you want to make sure you're going ahead and going to get that shit every day. Feel me? So once this process is over, when the Sun get into Taurus, you'll be able to have something to stand on, something to ground yourself with, versus you basically out here strifing and struggling when it comes to your feathers. See, when the Sun get into Taurus, you're going to experience some unexpected changes. You're also going to be basically dealing with your spiritual growth. So also, this is a time to basically not beat around the bush. It's the time to go ahead and go get it. Don't wait around, none of that shit. Feel me? You got the energy, you got the passion, you got the charge. You need to go ahead and basically charge things up and get shit flowing. So, yeah, the areas where you got Aries in your house, these are the areas where you're going to be focusing on your 30-day ritual and spell to basically create the sparks and create the initiatives and, of course, create the enthusiasm to go ahead and get that kickstart going and get that kickstart flowing. So you want to make sure you be in a motorcycle. You want to make sure you be in a ship. You want to make sure you're sailing constantly, moving constantly. Feel me? But, yeah, we're going to basically run it down when it comes to the houses and when it comes to the signs and when it comes to the aspects and the influences you're dealing with. But first thing first, we're going to go ahead and basically break down the suns and the moons real fast. But how this is going to influence you zodiac signs. And we're going to basically get into your houses. And we're going to basically break it down as far as how it's going to play out into your environment and what you see. So if you are Sun in Aries, Moon in Aries, Aries Ascendant, you guys are going to be basically dealing with a conjunction. So what is a conjunction? A conjunction is a stage, a platform, and of course, an environment, a territory which you're going to basically withstand all that power, withstand all that energy, withstand all those passions. So that means you're going to have a kickstart, a push. So go ahead and harness and utilize all the energy and all the passions that's going to be in the favoritism in your area. Feel me? Now, Tauruses, you guys are very fixated, stubborn, and of course, deeply rooted in your own ways of thinking and being practical. Now that we're in Aries season, you need to go ahead and utilize the semi-sextile, which is the difference maker when it comes to adapting to your changes. And of course, dealing with other ways to basically be very direct towards going to get it. Feel me? This ain't the time to be getting deeply rooted in the area. This is the time to basically go ahead and use a little bit of spark, a little bit of expression, a little bit of fire. go ahead and burn some shit down. There's some shit that you may have to get ready to release, or some shit that you may have to basically get ready to leave alone and start a new project, which is utilizing the other side of Scorpio. And also, we got the moon in Scorpio right now, too, where the moon falls and sleep at. So we're dealing with that sun and Aries exaltation, and we're dealing with that moon in Scorpio sleep mode. So, yeah, you go ahead, need to go ahead and get started on that aspect. Now, also, Geminis, you guys are going to have opportunities. Someone in sentences, you guys are going to have opportunities to express what's on your mind in a very impulsive, direct kind of manner, too. And it's 30-day cycle period. So make sure you're expressing the right methods. And, of course, the way you're expressing yourself is going to basically be an opportunity for you to basically go ahead and get things flowing and going. Also, Cancers, you guys are going to be learning how to express how you feel in a very direct manner, not holding things in, not barbling things in, or basically putting yourself into a situation. But you're going to be going to learning experiences when it comes to this 30-day process. So anything, wherever you got areas that are in your charts, you're going to be learning right now. And so you're going to be dealing with these experiences of learning. Also, for Leos, you guys are going to have the gift to exhaust yourself and outburn yourself, or deal with these influences, because the sun is exalted in Aries. So, of course, you can push yourself into the limit and go to the extremes right now when it comes to exaltation. So try not to exhaust yourself or burn yourself, though. But you're going to have the gift to express yourself in a very direct manner when it comes to what you're trying to attain and what you're trying to go after. Also, Virgo, Sun, Moon, and sentences, you guys are going to be basically dealing with some inconjunctions, some misunderstandings when it comes to being direct and passionate towards your goals. Because for me, you want to adapt to the changes, and of course, you want to utilize your skills and perfections in certain ways and certain endeavors. But right now, when we talk about fire, fire burns the earth, fire burns the reality. So of course, your reality need to be more perceptive of where you need to start out those grouply rounded bases. Of course, wherever you got Virgo at in your charts, these are going to be the areas where you need to go ahead and start replenishing a new way to basically create a new spark and a new light towards your goals, and of course your impetusations, and of course what you're trying to go ahead and be the initiative in. Also, Libras, you guys are going to be facing opposites. So that means you're going to be on the opposite side when it comes to this season, when it comes to Aries season. So that means you're going to be basically dealing with disconnections, dealing with opposing energies, or you could be the opposer as well, too, in different categories. But right now, you need to focus on yourself and valuing yourself, too, in this perspective, because you can't be in the codependent mode. This is the Aries season, so you want to make sure you put the right seeds in a bucket, put the right seeds in the fortune when it comes to basically being direct and, of course, what you're trying to achieve. Also, Scorpios, you guys will be seeing different ways of misunderstandings and conjunctions when it comes to expressing your deep desires. See, even though Scorpio and Aries are considered the same planet, the same way about going things. See, Scorpios is fixed water, so they like fix it in their own ways of dealing with the ice cubes, dealing with the waters, dealing with the sulkins. They don't really put themselves into situations of basically utilizing the spark or the initiative fire when it comes to the Aries sun, because Aries is predicated towards fire, Scorpio is water. Even though they're ruled by the same planets, the only difference is their modalities, you feel me? But Scorpios, you're going to be developing misunderstandings with going about developing your desires and your passions, depending on what kind of moon sign you have and depending on what kind of energies or elements that you're dealing with at this perspective. But you're also going to have that willpower as well, no matter what the stages are. But of course, you need to get ready, new and sparkative towards what you're trying to aim for. Sagittarius, is you guys will be seeing gifts. You guys are going to be dealing with a trine right now when it comes to your gifts and the way you express yourself. So you're going to have the gift to express your beliefs and, of course, what you're preaching and teaching in a very direct kind of manner. So you're going to have the gift to basically take the stage and express what's on your heart and, of course, what you need to be putting out there, too. Also, if you got Capricorn, someone in sentences, you guys are going to be dealing with learning experiences. But also, Aries is exalted in Capricorn. So that means you're going to have a whole lot of martial energy, a whole lot of energy, built-up energy, pent-up energy towards what you're trying to aim for when it comes to your goals and when it comes to your ways of being practical and stable and initiative. You're going to be basically utilizing a whole lot of direct energy in that area, too. So, of course, you're going to have that charge. But you got to learn how to utilize that charge and not just wait around trying to see how you're going to perfect your long-term goals. You just need to go ahead and go get out there and go get it. And then you can basically get into the other perspectives right now. But you need to be very direct and clear towards what you're going in. But you're also going to be dealing with some conflicts or some obstacles here and then. But it's all learning experiences, though. Also, Aquarius, you guys are going to be having opportunities to be unique and direct towards what you're trying to aim for or be passionate towards. Also, in this perspective, too, these opportunities are going to come. And these opportunities are going to be attracting its way into your light and the way you shine. So you want to make sure you are accumulating and, of course, and taking all these opportunities where you can basically be very direct and, of course, push yourself out there, push yourself forward after what you're trying to chase and what you're trying to associate yourself with. And last but not least, Pisces, Sun, Moon, and Sirius, you guys are going to be seeing different ways and different aspects to go about being direct towards your dreams, your imaginations, your fantasies, and, of course, your illusions. You guys will be dealing with changes, minor changes, where you need to basically look at the other side of being direct. And, of course, not trying to, like, bubble all these emotions that you're just basically trying to feel. So make sure you're not trying to feel all these emotions. Make sure these emotions or that you're feeling is being directed towards that aspect. And that brings us into the Chiron and Aries at the moment. So, of course, wherever you got Chiron at and Aries, these are going to be the areas where you're going to be feeling disconnected or feeling downgraded in some kind of aspect. Now, what's going to help you in this area is bringing equilibrium and balance towards areas where you need to go ahead and create the scales. And, of course, weigh in certain areas where you basically may be pushing or projecting yourself in certain locations and certain endeavors. You want to make sure you hold back on that. And if the scales are not weighing out in this aspect, you need to go ahead and basically take away those scales and those tables and retract on certain things too. So that's going to help you out a little bit when it comes to that balance and energy. So equilibrium and balance is key in this shit. Now, when it comes to your houses in Aries, feel me? Wherever you got Aries at in this house, you need to go ahead and spark a new vision, a new passion, a new desire, and a new way to feel and, of course, utilize your visions and your eyesights on what you're trying to aim for and what you're trying to go to. You want to make sure it's to the top is, yeah, you don't want to beat around the bush. You don't want to play around with this kind of energy. You want to go ahead and basically utilize these energies, harness these energies wherever you have them. And of course, keep pushing and keep utilizing that trailblazer. Now, if you got Aries in the first house, you are the Aries ascendant. So what you need to do here, utilize the conjunction. And of course, what you got going on when it comes to your personality and your personal life, you're going to be developing some expression trauma right here. Feel me? The trauma is going to be develop or equate it depending on how much good energies you was in when it was in Pisces season. That trauma can expand or can deteriorate, but it's up to you to basically express yourself, not have too much trauma in your endeavors, utilize that trauma to get you from point A to point B, which is whatever you're trying to maintain, and of course whatever you're trying to push forward to, and of course have a push start towards achieving your goals. You're also going to be attracting individuals that's very selfish or self-considered or self-centered at times too. So depending on these polar shifts, the seeds you plant right now, towards that 30-day process, towards the new moon also, is going to build up. So make sure that you're directing your expressions and, of course, how you appear to be to the world in a very direct kind of manner when it comes to achieving your goals. And, of course, what you're trying to chase, feel me? Go ahead and basically chase that personal endeavor, that personal desire. And, of course, you're going to be the leading example of what to do and what not to do when it comes to expressing yourself and, of course, utilizing your ego and, of course, your passions and your goals. Now, when it comes to you Tauruses, Sun, Moon, and Sirius, you guys are going to, I'm bugging. If you have Aries in the second house, you're going to be basically, you're a Pisces ascendant. So that means you're going to be seeing other sides of valuing yourself at this perspective. Or you're going to be basically dealing with misunderstandings when it comes to valuing yourself. This is also in conjunction in a semi-sextile perspective. So, what you need to do in this area, you need to value yourself, value your own resources, value your own way of being stable, and of course, get stubborn in that energy of valuing yourself right now, feel me? Have that focus and have that energy towards what you're trying to value and, of course, what you're trying to conquer. Because basically, how this is going to play out, when Taurus season comes, you're going to be basically able to have an environment, a surrounding, where you can have stability, safety and security that can basically play out into your aspect if you plant the right seeds when it comes to this arena of Sun being an Aries. But of course, you got to see in second house. So value more of yourself, value your self possessions, value that should be selfish in that area, and of course, create a little bit of equilibrium and balance when it comes to your eighth house, your desires and shit, and your deep desires. For me, add a little bit of secrets towards these certain things, still trying to tell everybody But also these deep desires and these rooted desires are gonna pop up, and that's what you're gonna basically be dealing with too, in this perspective. So try to bring some equilibrium and balance in there too when it comes to your relating deeply towards people, places, and things. Trying to burn too many bridges. Gemini, Sun, Moon, Ascendant. I'm bugging. If you got Aries in the third house, this is Aquarius Ascendant. So of course, you're gonna be placed into a situation of dealing having opportunities to be very direct, passionate, and of course, feeling and seeing a new way of expressing yourself when it comes to your environment, your surroundings, your friends. Now, if your friends ain't on go time or they ain't on green time, as far as like projections and as far as establishing goals, you're not with the right friends. And also, you need to create a little bit of equilibrium and balance, which is going to be in ninth house, your experiences, your moralities. Bring some higher aspects and higher beliefs in that area too, which is going to basically cater towards how you deal with these energies and these endeavors. Also, you got trauma here in this third house when it comes to your environment and, of course, your friends. You may basically be placed into a situation of not being valued by friends, or the information, the ideas that you basically express is not going to be basically valued by the individual that you're with. Now, if these individuals don't value expressions, you need to go ahead and let loose of these motherfuckers. And, of course, get them out of your space and tell them to see you later. Now, if you got Aries in the fourth house, you are Capricorn, someone in the sentence. So you're going to be basically learning how to feel and see new ways on being direct towards your home, your family, and of course your privacies. You may be basically be dealing with some whole lot of conflict when it comes to these energies and these individuals that you live with. But also, you need to come up with a new way of establishing your own home, your own way of basically being very direct. And of course, not placing your energies and your passions towards going to war or going into the army or some shit. You need to basically have a new way of being very direct and passionate towards your home and your comfortability. And of course, what makes you feel good at home too, feel me? Or just be overprotective towards your home and your family at this perspective. It's gonna play out in your favor. Do your home rituals, do your room rituals and shit. Make sure you're doing your safety, secure rituals in your house to keep everything sacred and, of course, protected in that area too. Also, if you got Aries in the fifth house, you're going to basically be having a gift right now when it comes to your expressions and your creative endeavors. Also, you need to come up with new ways of sparking your creativities, your talents, your hobbies, your gifts, your traits, and, of course, your arts. You're also developing some trauma in this area too when it comes to how you express yourself, feel me? What's going to help you is going to be your 11th house, your unknown individuals, unknown circumstances, unknown situations. Now, the public is going to basically be the kind of like the help. You're going to expect some unexpected help when it comes to the public, unknown individuals and shit. That's going to kind of like help boost you up a little bit, which create equilibrium and balance for you to basically go ahead and push towards your expressions and, of course, your creative endeavors. But use this trauma to go ahead and basically climb the ladder and, of course, achieve what you're trying to manifest. And, of course, it's going to place you into a better predicament to make you feel comfortable with yourself and, of course, you expressing your endeavor. So your creativities, your hobbies and shit, focus on that as a 30-day ritual and spell. Put a whole lot of energy in that area. And, of course, be very self-direct in that area too. Also, if you have Aries in the sixth house, you're going to be basically dealing with in conjunction, misunderstandings about paying attention towards your routines, your health, what you do on a day-to-day basis, feel me? Also, in this placement right here, what you need to focus on is basically be very direct towards getting your own shit, getting your own work routine, getting your own health going on, getting your own way of doing things, feel me? In this house, you're gonna be developing a whole lot of trauma if you don't get your shit together. People may basically be taking a whole lot of credibility of you. People basically may basically be me overlooking you or some shit. Or what you do on a day-to-day basis and your routine may be very unappreciative. Now, use that energy towards, you know, developing yourself and, of course, pushing yourself to higher extents. Feel me? Because all that vulnerability energy that you're feeling and dealing with, that's going to kind of, like, you know, be reciprocated in good ways or bad ways, depending on you being the sender. And, of course, the creator in that area and that aspect. Also, what's going to basically help you is your dreams, your imagination, your fantasy. That's where you got Libra at in that house. So use it a whole lot. You blend your dreams and, of course, your routine in that aspect. And, of course, you use your work or your health ethics to basically push you forward and, of course, get things going and flowing, get the juices running and stowing. And, of course, get yourself good together and, of course, pictate in that area and get more organized in that area, and you're going to be all right. Also, if you have Aries in the seventh house, you're going to be very codependent. Also, you're going to be developing some trauma when it comes to your relationships, your partnerships, and, of course, how you express yourself in your romantic endeavors. You're going to develop some trauma here. What you basically need to do is love yourself. But also, you need to come up with a new way of basically having passions, goals, orientation towards how you relate towards individuals and shit. Or you may basically be attracting these individuals, these self-centered individuals at times too, or aggressive individuals or arguments and shit. You're going to be developing a whole lot of that because you're going to kind of like on the opposite end. Aries don't really like this house because it's the other side of Aries, but also it's going to basically be in the perspective of wanting to do things in itself. And of course, it's going to be placed into a situation of you guys developing opposites or attracting the opposite differences and shit. But of course, if it's all about some status and some goals where these things can get rectified, you can use your partner or your relationship as a ritual, as a 30-day ritual and spell to basically get you going or the way you relate to shit. Also, you got Aries in the 8th house. It's a Virgo ascendant. So, of course, you're going to be placed into a situation of developing a whole lot of misunderstandings when it comes to worrying about your desires, your deep motivations, and, of course, what motivation, of course, will get you up out of bed. You're going to be developing some trauma when it comes to your sexual urges, your deep desires, your deep intent, your deep passion shit. Try to, like, not allow these shits to basically throw you off perspective. Use a little bit of your second house. Get more grounded, get more stabilized, get more practical. And of course, whatever you're doing behind closed doors, with the lights off and shit, make sure that's kind of like that ritual spell is going to basically build you up and, of course, put you into the better perspective, a better perspective, and of course, a better way of going about things when it comes to expressing yourself and, of course, pushing yourself forward. Also, if you got Aries in the 9th house, you're going to be placed into a situation of developing a gift. But that gift is also going to be something that you get comfortable with. So try not to get too comfortable with your gift. Feel me? You're also going to be developing some form of trauma when it comes to your experiences, your beliefs, your traveling, your enthusiasm, your way of basically sparking religious beliefs and spirituality endeavors. You're going to be developing some trauma in that area too. Try to utilize this trauma to help you out, which is going to be placed into your environment, your surroundings, your friends. Feel me? You could basically be a bigger picture, a bigger outlet for them, or school and shit. Or you get your school shit going too. You can maybe come up with a school, or just come up with your better ways of being a technique when it comes to expressing your teacher endeavors, or your principles, or your laws, or your ethics and shit. Try to, like, you know, get more deeply into that area, and of course, get ready to expand that shit and take that shit off to a higher perspective and a higher domain. Also, if you got Aries in the 10th house, you're going to be placed into a situation of overexhausting yourself, but also going through learning experiences and conflict when it comes to expressing your passion, your goals, and of course, what you're being known for when it comes to your status, how others see you, how others know you, how others are admired by you and shit. I mean, make sure your status and your goals, make sure you're kind of like selfish in that area too. You're also going to be developing some trauma when it comes to how you're seen and what you're known for and shit too. Your status going to be going through conflict. You could basically be very unaware about certain things, or you could be developing some trauma when it comes to what you're seeing and what you're known for in these areas. Use that trauma to get you push you forward, or use your home, your family, or your kids and shit like that. Use like things that make you comfortable to basically help you out and put you into a better perspective, because you got Libra in your 4th house, which is your home, your family. So that's going to bring equilibrium and balance when it comes to what you're expressing and, of course, what you're putting out there too. So bring that together. This is going to help you not ruffle any feathers, but this is also going to create a bridge where you can heal that trauma and clear that trauma out too. Also, if you got Aries in the 11th house, you're going to be basically you're going to have opportunities to be very direct towards the public, be very direct towards your groups, your acquaintances, which, of course, which you associate yourself with. You're also going to be developing some trauma when it comes to groups, acquaintances, which you're expressing on the internet or the networking skills and shit like that. You're going to be developing some trauma. Now, use that trauma to help you out a little. For me, put more creativity and endeavors towards your expressions yourself, creativity, which is going to be your 5th house and shit. For me, use a little bit of that 5th house energy to blend it in with that 11th house which is gonna kind of like pretty much help you out in the situation, because you got Libra in the fifth house. So make sure you share, like, trying to confiscate the stage, but of course make sure you're sharing the stage just a little bit with individuals that's in your group. This way everybody else won't be basically, you know, feeling left out or having some ways of reacting and responding to you in some kind of perspective. So also use a little bit of that energy too to help you up and build you up a little bit, so you guys can come together and of course not have no differences when it comes to expressing yourself and of course what you got going on. Also, last but not least, if you have Aries in the 12th house, you're going to be placed into the situation of seeing different sides, to be very direct and passionate towards your dreams, your imaginations, your beliefs, your morals, and morality. What's going to basically help you is going to be your 6th house, which is where you got Libra at. Also, you're going to be developing some trauma when it comes to your dreams. And, of course, your privacy, your subconscious. Feel me? Things that you're dealing with internally. These energies are going to come out of the blue. You're just going to feel guilty about certain things, or just feel unsatisfied about certain things, or feel kind of like detached about certain things. Use those feelings and question those feelings too. Use those feelings towards areas where you want to feel comfortable at, feel great at, feel me? And create some sparks and equilibrium and balance towards these areas. You might develop secret enemies, or you may basically be placed into a situation of dealing with inner demons and shit like that. So make sure you are cleaning out your space and, of course, putting yourself into a better environment and a better predicament to basically push forward and get yourself going. And, of course, that's how the Aries season is going to play out when it comes to the Sun, Moon, and Ascendancies, and, of course, wherever you have these at. So you're going to be very, what you need to be focusing on is being very direct, going and get it, and, of course, making sure that you are first to go ahead and basically get that worm. Feel me? You got to be first to get the worm. But also, you got to also create a little bit of you get a little bit of balance wherever you got Libra at, because Libra is going to basically help things out, help scale things, help weigh things out. That's when you're into all Aries and shit. But of course, your focus and your energy and your intention is going to be on that. But the moon signs is where you're going to basically be reacting and responding to the seeds that's being planted in these areas, and seeds that's being orchestrated and, of course, penetrated in these areas. So yeah, be aware of that area where you got those at in your charts. And of course, everybody going to be having this connections, learning experiences, opportunities, and gifts. But of course, that don't mean you sit on your ass and get lazy. Go ahead and keep fighting, of course, winning a great fight. And of course, get your shit going.